Hello, and thank you for tuning in to Eskaton Talks. I am your host, Therese Tenbrink.
And I'm Darlene Cullivan. Today we are partnering with Roseville Area Chamber of Commerce to talk about staying connected, because none of us want to let social distancing lead us into a social recession.
I think a lot of us are feeling like we're in the middle of a social recession right now, Darlene. I know I feel this way at times.
Exactly. So let's dive right into today's topic. We're going to be reviewing the social nature of humans and why this social recession is so hard on us social creatures. Then we're going to review the benefits of social connections. And lastly, we're going to provide some easy ways to continue to stay emotionally connected despite social distancing.
Sounds great, Darlene. I know for me personally, I'm a social creature and I need to be around other people in order to get my energy. But evolutionarily speaking, we are all social creatures by nature. As far back as we can trace, as humans have traveled, hunted, and thrived in social groups, and for good reason. Humans who were separated from their tribe often suffered severe consequences. Social groups provide us with an important part of our identity, and more than that, they teach us a set of skills that help us to live our lives. Feeling social connected is especially important during this time. The benefits of social connectedness shouldn't be overlooked just because we are social distancing. So, Darlene, can you tell us why being socially connected is so important?
Absolutely. Overall, science shows that being connected improves your quality of life. If you've ever moved away from your social home base, then you have a good idea of just how much social connections shape your everyday life and your well-being. One study showed that social connection is a greater determinant to health than obesity, smoking, and even high blood pressure.
Not only that, but it has shown to also boost your mental health. Friendships offer a number of mental health benefits, such as increased feelings of belonging, purpose, increased feelings of happiness, reduced levels of stress, and even improved feelings of self-worth and confidence, Darlene.
Yes, and that's probably why some say friendship is like food. We need it not only to survive, but we also need it to thrive. And studies show now even that friendships help us live longer. Research has shown that social connections not only impact your mental health, but your physical health as well. A review of 148 studies, including over 300,000 participants, indicated that the individuals with stronger social relationships had a 50% increase likelihood of survival. This remained true across the number of factors, including age, sex, health status, and cause of death.
So that's why our first tip for staying connected is connect with a friend. And fortunately, social connection does not mean you have to be physically present with people in the literal sense, which is good news for all of us as we are social distancing and not able to be physically close to one another right now. Also, as long as we feel physically connected and as long as we feel emotionally connected and well-known, we continue to see the benefits of our friendships. So this is a good excuse to call or write a letter to your friends or family, because this helps us stay emotionally connected while being physically apart. If you have a loved one or a friend who is in need of extra social connection, encourage them to join Eskaton's telephone reassurance program for a daily wellness check-in call.
Well, I think that is great news, because all of us understand how calling our friends seems like such a simple and important way to remain connected. Another tip is to connect digitally. Technology has made it so easy to stay connected and to connect virtually. If you have a smartphone, computer, or tablet, you're just one click away from being connected. FaceTime, Skype, or Google Hangout, they're just a few ways that you can try to actually see your loved ones in real time.
I love this idea of connecting virtually with your friends online. Darlene, have you given that a try?
I love connecting with friends. Every Saturday morning, five of my girlfriends, we drink coffee together and are able to see each other's faces and share and laugh, and it brings such comfort to my soul.
I absolutely love that. I know my friends and I were doing a regular happy hour sometime after work every week, which has been so great.
That is great.
So even if you are chatting with your family or friends regularly, it is still likely that you may be feeling lonely during this time. And that's okay, and that's also very normal. And we want you to know that there are other ways for you to reclaim your connection, both with yourself and with your environment, which will leads us right into our third tip, which is connecting with nature. According to research, living close to nature and spending time outside has significant and wide-ranging health benefits. A new report reveals that exposure to green space reduces the risk of type 2 diabetes, cardiovascular disease, premature death, stress, and high blood pressure. We also now know that spending just 90 minutes outside can even lower activity in the prefrontal cortex of the brain, which is the region of the brain that focuses on those negative emotions. So not only does nature improve your physical health, Darlene, it can also improve your mental well-being and reduce those negative emotions you may be having. So just going outside can also help you feel connected to your neighbors and community while keeping a safe distance. So going on daily walks or still working in the garden, those are all fantastic ways to continue to stay connected to your community during this time.
I agree, and I love the idea of spending time with nature to reconnect. Another tip is also incorporating more physical touch into your life. Lack of physical connection can be the cause of loneliness. In fact, when we were babies, our bodies were trained to respond to physical touch as a form of communication and connection with our caregivers.
So even if you don't consider yourself a touchy-feely person, physical contact has always been at the center of feeling safe, secured, and cared for. But you don't need a spouse, a friend, or a massage therapist necessarily to give you that reassuring caress or touch. Try placing your hand over your heart and taking a few deep breaths. This can help you reconnect with yourself.
What I find so interesting about touch trace is that our bodies register the care we give ourselves in a similar way that it registers the care we get from others through physical touch.
That is so interesting. And what a perfect gift that you can give to yourself. And really just to provide yourself with a little extra reassurance during these unsettling times. Another tip is getting creative, which has been my go-to during the last few weeks. Sketching, painting, knitting, or writing, anything that may just get your creative juices flowing, we highly recommend doing it. We know that creative arts have an extraordinary capacity to elevate and transcend our negative emotional experiences through self-expression, which is also easy to do in your home. If you don't have the right supplies, purchase them from an online retailer. Some simple ideas to get you started is just purchasing an adult coloring book, coloring pencils, paintbrushes, cardstock paper, and painting by numbers. Anytime I find myself getting stressed or overwhelmed, I pull out my coloring pencils and just doodle. And that seems to always provide some clarity and some reconnection for myself.
I love that. And also a great lead into our last tip. Learn something. Learn anything. Attend a virtual class or event. Museums, zoos, theaters, dance, and art studios, they are all getting very creative, and they're offering opportunities to enjoy what they offer typically, but in a digital format. Even better, many of these activities are available for free. So find something that you have always found interesting and give it a try. We have a whole list of ideas available on our website, eskaton.org.
Darlene, have you tried any classes online yet?
I love cooking classes online. I've enjoyed learning how to make authentic egg rolls, tortillas, and Thai food.
Wonderful. I just recently started doing an online yoga class, which has been wonderful.
That's great.
So that is going to bring us to our 6 tips for staying healthy and connected. We hope that you found these tips very helpful, and either you and your loved ones can find new creative ways to stay connected with one another. And for more information on staying connected, we hope that you will visit eskaton.org/social connections.
Thanks so much for joining us today.